Hi everyone, welcome. In this video, I'm going to show you how to check a number is palindrome number or not. So basically, a palindrome number is a number that remains the same when its digits are reversed. So for example, if I say 16461, if I reverse the same number, again you will get 16461. So this is a palindrome number. Now we'll see how we can do this through programmatically. So first of all, to check a number is palindrome or not, we need to reverse a number, and then we'll compare the reverse number with original number. If both are equal, then we can say it is a palindrome number. So here we need to use a logic for reverse a number. So if you remember in my previous video, I have explained how to reverse a number in three different ways. The same logic again, I'm going to use it here. So first of all, let me just create a new class. I will name it as palindrome number. Let's take a main method, then finish. So here I'll just accept a number from the user. So for that I can say a scanner class, scanner LC is equal to new scanner. And here I need to pass one argument. Let's say system.in and then semicolon. Now import the scanner from java.util. And here, so then I'll display some message to the user so that user will know he has to enter some value. Let's say system.out.println. Here I'll say enter a number and then semicolon. So whatever number the user is entered, I can just accept the number into a variable. I'll create one variable called number, and here scanner object dot next int. So I'm accepting a integer value. So I'm just say next int is a method which will accept the value and store that into this variable. So now we need to reverse this number. After reversing, again, the reverse number is exactly the same as original number. Then we can say it is a palindrome number. So for that, what I can do is I will also take one more additional variable. I'll name it as org underscore number. Let's say original number is equal to number. So whatever number I accepted from the user, I'm just storing that number, exactly the same number in the original number. And I will use this original number at the end of the program. So now we need to reverse this particular number. So to reverse this number, I have already explained three different ways how we can reverse a number. Let me take one of the logic, and I'm just reusing the same logic here. And if you notice here, this particular code will reverse a number. Suppose if you just notice here, I have written while loop, okay, which will reverse a number. So initially I take reverse is equal to zero, and this particular logic will find the will reverse a number, and finally this variable contains a reverse value. Now let me just print it, system.out.println, and just print the reverse variable, and let's see whether it is able to reverse or not. Let me just run as Java application. Now here I'm giving some number, let's say 1234 as an input, then 4321 output we got. So that means it is properly reversed. Now we need to compare this reverse number into our with our original number. Then if both are equal, then we can say number is a palindrome number. So here I'm going to write a if condition. Okay, let me write one if condition here. I'll say if the original number, which is equal to our reverse number, and then you can say system.out.println. So number is palindrome number. So I can also print that number here, that is original number. Concatenation, and here I'll say palindrome number. Okay, both are equal, original number and reverse number both are equal, I'll say palindrome number. And if not, else here I'll say number is not palindrome number. So number not palindrome number, right? So that's how we can verify whether a number is palindrome number or not. So once it is reversed, we need to compare the reverse value with original number. If both are same, we can say palindrome number. If both are not same, it is a not palindrome number. Now let us test this. So let me run as a Java application. Now here I'm just giving 1234. This is when you reverse this number, it will not give you the same number. So it is not palindrome. So it is saying not palindrome number. Now when I execute one more time, so this time I'll give one more value. Let's say 164. And 61, 164 and 61. And when you reverse this again, you will get the same number, So it is a palindrome number, right? So this is how we can check a number is palindrome number or not. All right. So that's all for this video, guys. Thanks for watching.